फिर से स्वागत है आपका आनंद राज केमिस्ट्री क्लासेस में।
स्पेशल पार्ट ऑफ द एसिड बेस एंड सॉल्ट वी डिस्कस अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन रिलेटेड टू एसिड बेस राइट देन वी डिस्कस अबाउट द केमिकल एंड फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी देन वी डिस्कस हाउ टू फाइंड आउट द स्ट्रेंथ देन नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज इंडिकेटर सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इंडिकेटर्स टाइप्स ऑफ सॉल्ट एंड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सॉल्ट दिस पार्ट इज गाइस Concentrate first of all. Let me explain. So I have muted all of you. First focus, then I'll unmute you all. Indicators are first of all weak acid or weak base, and they are organic compound. Okay. Now indicators first of all. This is a chemical composition. Weak acid or weak base, and they are organic compound. Second part, what's the use of indicators? So indicators are used to find the nature of solution. Nature of solution, either is acidic, basic, or neutral. Right. So like when we walk on the road, so there are some indicators. If we have to take left, there is an indicator in the left hand side. When we have to take right, then we have to use the indicator in the right hand side direction. So similarly, indicators tells about the nature of the solution. Okay. Now let me give you some example of indicators. These are the common indicators which we are going to use in class 10th, 11th, and 12th also. But in class 10, what are the indicators are important? I will mark here. Red litmus is important. Blue litmus, universal indicator, phenolphthalein, red cabbage water. Okay. Now we know when we talk about indicators, acid changes blue litmus to red. So now when we talk about red litmus, less than 7 means acidic medium. The color of litmus paper will be red in nature and blue in basic medium. Correct? Now, sorry, not this one, these two part. So litmus paper have red color in acidic medium, blue color in basic medium. Next part is phenolphthalein. This is important. In acidic medium is colorless, neutral also colorless, but in basic medium it changes to pink and red. How to find out which color? So pink we when talk about, it talks about mild base. Red, it will be in strong basic medium. Okay, so there are two colors for phenolphthalein, pink and red. Pink in mild basic region and red in strong basic region. Another part is methyl orange. Okay, methyl orange is yellow in neutral medium, orange in basic medium, and pink in basic medium. Sorry, orange in acidic medium, yellow in neutral, and pink in basic medium. So this is about methyl orange. And last important is universal indicator. Okay, so universal indicator have tendency to show color based on pH. I'll show you in separate board. Now let's talk about universal indicator. Okay, so universal indicator color in neutral medium pH is equal to 7. It shows green color. When we talk about this medium, strong acidic medium, it has red color, then it changes to orange, then it changes to yellow and green. In basic medium, it changes from blue, violet, and purple. Okay, so weak basic medium blue, strong basic medium is purple. So this is the color range of universal indicator. So guys, tell me quickly if this color part related to universal indicator is clear. Everyone. Perfect, perfect, guys. Okay, so in neutral medium is green, in acidic medium red, orange and yellow, in basic medium blue, violet and purple. Chalo, so let's try one question related to this. Quickly guys, I'll give you the mic, valid option, answer this. Everyone, and after 10 minutes, I'll give the coin also. Those who will stay for 20 minutes, I'll give the coin. Which will show color change with litmus paper? Dekho. Main thing is behavior towards the litmus paper will occur if there are ions present, right? Ions are always present in aqueous medium, not under dry condition. Dry will not show, but aqueous will break into H plus and Cl minus, right? Okay, so the acidic behavior is always present when H plus ions are present. I hope everyone is clear with this. Let me end the valid. Let's see what is the correct answer. Yes, option B, HCl aqueous will show the color change with litmus paper. HCl dry will not break into ions. Is it clear, everyone? Okay, and one more thing, guys. Please don't spam in chat box. And there is a one more option, especially for those students who don't want to interact with the useless chat. Go in the right corner and select the option of chat with teacher and mentor, sir. That's it. Okay. Chalo, let's try another problem. This is really good question and they have asked in board exam. I'll give you 20 second time. I want you to answer this properly. Think about it and answer this. It's a simple question, guys. Everyone, please type in the chat box. Okay, what is the action of litmus paper on these two cases? Dry ammonia gas. Just now I said dry compound will not show any effect on litmus paper. So no change. Now solution of ammonia gas in water. So when we say ammonia gas in water, it forms NH4OH. And this is what? Basic in nature or base. It is base. It will convert red litmus to blue, right? So in this case, no change. In this case, red litmus to blue. So let me end the valid, guys. Let's see what is the correct answer. Option A is the correct answer. So guys, tell me quickly if this particular part is clear. Fast. Press one if it is clear. And again, I'm repeating, this is our last class from 21 days free course. From tomorrow, there is a separate course for 19 days. Do enroll for that, everyone. Chalo. Try this question, guys, again. These questions are logical questions and based on the concept. Read the question two times, three times, then try to answer this. Okay. Two solution X and Y are tested with universal indicator. Solution X turns orange where solution Y turns red. Which of the solution is strong acid? So before answering this question, guys, I'll show you the range of universal indicator. See, this is acid. Okay, take the reference of this particular table related to universal indicator, then you can answer this. I'll give you 5 second time to take the reference of this, then I'll go back to the original question. Clear, everyone? Okay. Cool. So now you can answer this particular question, guys. There are two solutions, X and Y. X turns orange where Y turns red. Universal indicator. So we know for acidic medium, universal indicator, it changes from red, orange to yellow. Correct? Now, this is for strong medium, this is for mild acidic, and this is for weak acidic medium. Clear? Now we have X which turns orange. So Y, X will come here, and Y turns red. So Y will come here. So now based on that, we can figure out which one will be our more acidic solution. Hope everything is clear now, guys. So the correct answer is Y. Guys, tell me quickly if this part is clear, everyone. Very good. Chalo, let's try this one. Again, let me help you with the help of table. Now, the table was this particular thing. This table, you can use to solve any kind of question. We have related to universal indicator, litmus paper, phenolphthalein, and methyl orange. Phenolphthalein is colorless in acidic medium, neutral medium, but it is pink or red in basic medium. Universal indicator, this color. So let's go to the original question, guys. We will solve that. Okay, now two solutions P and Q have pH value this. Which of these will turn litmus solution from blue to red? Okay, so when I'm saying blue to red, what is the main condition? Blue to red will be converted by basic medium, right? Which will turn phenolphthalein, acidic medium, my bad. Blue to red, it should be acidic in nature. Second, phenolphthalein from colorless to pink. Just now we saw the table. Phenolphthalein in acidic medium is colorless, neutral is colorless. It changes to pink or red in basic medium. So this should be your basic medium. Okay. So the first, now we have given with the pH value, right? Let me end the valid. Let's check. pH of this is 3. So it means it's acidic. The first part answer will be P. pH of Q is 9.5. It is basic. And the answer for this will be Q. So now answer for this particular question. First part is P. Second part is Q. Okay, Utkarsh, I'll tell you, no need to know the formula for phenolphthalein. But only one thing I can tell you, phenolphthalein or methyl orange, they are aromatic organic compound. Okay, do remember this. Either phenolphthalein or methyl orange, they are aromatic organic compound. Okay, now someone has doubt in this. See this part. It turns litmus paper blue to red. It means it should be acidic in nature because acid changes blue litmus to red. Second, phenolphthalein from colorless to pink. We know the table. Phenolphthalein changes to pink in basic medium. It should be basic. So out of these two solutions, P is acidic and Q is basic. So now for first answer will be P. For second answer will be Q. Hope now is everything clear to everyone. Press 1 if it is clear. Chalo, very good. Now tell me answer for this. It's a simple question. It's a really simple question, guys. Try to answer this. Now what we have to do, we have to just use universal indicator table. So one more time, I will show you the universal indicator table. That is this one. Green color for neutral, for acidic medium, red, orange, yellow, for basic medium, blue, violet, and purple. So let's go to the original question and answer this, guys. I'm giving you violet. 10 second time. Answer this, guys. Okay, so they are asking color of distilled water with universal indicator. Distilled water is neutral in nature, right? So now you know what will be the color. So let me end the valid. 5 more seconds, guys. Answer this quickly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, very good, very good. So let me end the valid. Let's see what is the color. Green color. Now it's the time for allotting the coins. Let's give it to you. Everyone, take the coin now. Wow. So everyone has got the coin. Let's go back and check the next topic. Okay. This question is really, really important. I know most of you won't be able to answer this, but I want you to try this question. I'll tell you some important thing related to this particular topic. Okay. So try to think about it and answer this. Then I will explain about this. I'll give you the list of color of precipitate formed by some specific ion. And from that particular list, minimum one question will be asked. Okay. So try to think about it, answer it. Then I'll give you the list. So now what we are doing, we are adding sodium hydroxide to aqueous solution of ferrous sulfate. Okay, so let me tell you list, important list of hydroxide color. Dekho. FeOH whole twice, it is dirty green. Okay, FeOH whole thrice, it is reddish brown. Zinc OH whole twice, it is gelatinous white. PbOH whole twice is a chalky white. Okay, another thing, CuOH whole twice is pale blue. Okay, so now these are the some important hydroxide related to color. Guys, tell me quickly if this part is clear. Now you can answer this, guys. And now I want everyone to answer this. I have given you the list. Now figure out what will be the color. Everyone, this table is really important. Minimum one question they will be asking in board exam. Okay? Chalo. So now this is ferrous sulfate. Ferrous means which ion? Fe2 plus. Right. Fe2 plus will form hydroxide. FeOH whole twice. So now guys, tell me the correct answer. FeOH whole twice will be green precipitate. Everyone, is it clear? I can see most of you have answered option D, but now I've given you ferrous means Fe2 plus. Fe2 plus is from dirty green. So let me end the valid. Let's check the correct answer is green. Okay, guys. So tell me quickly if this particular question is clear. It was little different, but important question for a board exam. Okay, very nice. This question, okay, this is question of the day. Now, I'll discuss this question at the end of this class. Okay, before that, I'll tell you related to solve topics, some important terms like water of crystallization, efflorescence, deliquescence, hygroscopic. Okay, guys, so let's go and understand the next topic, soil. Okay, now, salt is what exactly? Salt is formed by reaction of acid and base when they are neutralizing each other. So salts are formed by neutralization reaction. Okay, acid, base will react to form salt plus water. So guys, I have one question related to this because I have this part in chapter one also. Okay, what kind of reaction is this? I'll mute all of you. What type of reaction is this? Option A, exothermic. Option B, endothermic. This is neutralization reaction. Quickly answer this. I think everyone knows about this. First, neutralization is what type of chemical reaction? Quickly, guys, answer this first. Okay, and after three more questions, I'll give one important question related to point. If you will answer that particular question, or more than 90% people will answer that question, I'll give the coins. Okay, guys, I think this is easier. All neutralization reactions are exothermic in nature. We have already discussed about this. Heat is released. Salt plus water plus heat. Okay, so let me end the wallet. Let's see. Now we'll discuss about these five types of salt. Okay, let me explain in the next part. Normal salt. Second is acidic salt. Third is basic salt. Fourth is mixed salt. And last one is double salt. Okay, so when we talk about normal salt, it is formed by reaction of strong acid plus strong base. Normal salt is formed by reaction of strong acid and strong base. Example, NaCl, K2SO4, etc. Acidic salt, concentrate guys, some concepts are involved in this. Formed by strong acid and weak base. So dominating part will be strong acid. Example, NH4Cl, etc. Okay? Basic salt, it is formed by weak acid plus strong base. Example is weak acid and Na2CO3. Okay, so this is one example for this. Mixed salt. Okay, this is little tough definition. Let me explain in the proper and simple way. Mixed salt contain more than one type of cations or anions. Okay, they contains more than one type of cations or anions. Example, I'll take as a bleaching powder. Okay, can anyone tell the formula for this? I'll unmute all of you. Can anyone tell the formula for this? Quickly, guys. Okay. Okay, it's okay, Manu, if you don't know. I'm just asking if you know about this. The formula is CaOCl2. Okay, cool. Don't worry about that. See, what I said, this is example of mixed salt. Now, what I said, it contains more than one type of cations or anions. So when bleaching powder breaks, it breaks into Ca2+, Cl- and OCl-. It contains two type of anion. What is the condition? More than one type of cations or anions. It contains more than one type of anions. This is the example of mixed salt. Okay, so tell me guys quickly if this part is clear. Everyone, normal salt, acidic salt, basic salt and mixed salt. This was little tough but interesting topic. Quickly guys, so I can explain further about the double salt. Okay, so now let me explain you about double salt. Okay, double salt is combination of two simple salt. Two simple salt. Example is potassium alum. Okay, most of you must have heard about this potassium alum. So tell me how many of you are aware about this term, potassium alum. If you know, press one. If you don't know, press two. बेटा इसका हिंदी में नाम क्या होता है? फिटकरी. बहुत सारे नॉर्थ इंडियन लोगों ने इसको एज ए फिटकरी के नाम से सुना होगा, राइट? ओके, नाउ पोटैशियम एलम, देयर आर टू थ्री पर्पस. इज यूज्ड फॉर प्यूरिफाइंग द वाटर. इट इज यूज्ड एज डिसइंफेक्टेंट आल्सो. सो व्हाट वी डू, वी आर डिपिंग इनटू द वाटर, इट एब्जॉर्ब्स द इम्प्योरिटी एज and it kills the bacteria also. Okay, so this is the general purpose. Let me tell you the formula for this. Formula is K2SO4 dot Al2SO4 whole thrice dot 24 S. So this is one simple salt, this is another simple salt. So combination of these two is known as double salt. Okay, is it clear everyone? Simple sa formula hai. क्या करना है, फिगर आउट करना है कितने नॉर्मल सॉल्ट्स हैं. इफ देयर आर टू नॉर्मल सॉल्ट्स तो वी कैन से ये हमारा डबल सॉल्ट है. ओके गाइस, क्विकली टेल मी फास्ट, प्रेस वन इफ इट इज क्लियर, प्रेस टू इफ नॉट. यस बेटा, यस. इवन द समवन आस्क्ड अबाउट बेकिंग सोडा NaH CO3. It contains Na plus, H plus and CO3 2 minus. This is also example of mixed salt. Okay, cool, perfect. Chalo, let's discuss another question related to that. Now I am giving you 15 second time guys, answer this. If you will answer this, definitely I'll get the coin. Everyone, if you will answer this question, I'll give you a coin. Everyone, think about it and answer this. Name the acid and base which are used to form this particular salt. Sodium acetate. Everyone, 15 second time. It's easy. You need to remember the concept related to previous class or last to last class when we discuss about classification of acid and bases. Everyone, answer this. It's an easy question. Sodium acetate, right? Sodium means Na plus ion, acetate means CH3COO- ion. So based on that, we can say it is form of NaOH and CH3COH. this is our acid and this is our base. So now I think everyone is clear. Let me end the valet. Let's see what is the correct answer. Yes, option A is correct answer. Okay, so now only 80% people have answered this. Okay, I'll give one more chance, guys. One more chance. If you'll answer this, I want 90% people to answer correctly. Answer this, 200% I'll give the coin. Quickly, same kind of question. Name the acid and base related to ammonium chloride. Quickly, guys, everyone. Okay, now 85% people have answered option B. Let's see what could be the best. Chalo, 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 jaldi karo. Still 50 more people have to answer. Easy air, ammonium chloride. Ammonium ion kya hota hai mera beta? NH4, chloride is minus. So definitely based on that, we can figure out this should be NH4OH and ester. So option B will be our correct answer. Yes, very good. Who opted option B? Now it's a coin time. Chalo, 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 jaldi se le lo. Quickly, everyone. One more second. Very good, very good. Chalo. So this was the question related to types of salt. Okay? Chalo, let's solve this question, guys. Okay. Now, think about it, then answer it. We need to know what type of acid and base are used to form normal salt, right? If you remember, I told it is formed by strong acid and strong base. So, jaldi se answer kar do bata. Simple sa hai. Aur sare questions conceptual questions hai, theek hai? To socho aur uske baad answer karo. Easy है यार, तुम लोग कर सकते हो. अभी सारी चीजें तुम लोगों ने सीख ली हैं और तुम लोग स्मार्ट तो हो ही यार. चलो नहीं, आई विल गिव अनदर टाइम, ठीक है? सो डोंट वरी अबाउट कॉइंस. जल्दी से करो यार. सिंपल, देखो, स्ट्रॉन्ग एसिड एंड स्ट्रॉन्ग बेस, दे विल न्यूट्रलाइज ईच अदर, ठीक है? सो द पीएच विल बी 7. सो ऑप्शन बी विल बी आवर correct answer. Yes, close the valet and tell me quickly if this part is clear. pH of normal salt will be 7. Is it clear, everyone? Quickly. Very good. Acha, ye answer karo jaldi se. What will be the pH of ammonium chloride? Same question hai, but in different way. First of all, we need to find out what is acid, what is base involved in this, and what type of those acid and base are. If we can figure out, then easily we can tell the pH. So, main wallet open kar raha hu, jaldi se kar do yaar. Interesting question hai. Simple hai, but interesting hai. So now I'm getting mixed kinds of answer. बहुत सारे बच्चे लोग A कर रहे हैं, बहुत सारे B. देखो, मैं एक hint देता हूँ बच्चों. Try to find out acid and base related to this. If you remember in the previous question we did it, क्या था हमारा base? NH4OH and acid is S. ठीक है? NH4OH क्या है हमारा बेटा? Weak base है. HCl क्या है हमारा? Strong acid. तो स्ट्रॉन्ग एसिड और वीक बेस मिलके क्या बना रहे हैं हमारे? एसिडिक सॉल्ट. ठीक है, नाउ आप लोग बता सकते हो कि इसकी पीएच कितनी हो. आई थिंक दिस पार्ट इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन. कॉन्सेप्ट वाइज टेल मी क्विकली इफ द कॉन्सेप्ट इज क्लियर रिलेटेड टू दिस क्वेश्चन. एवरीवन प्रेस वन इफ द कॉन्सेप्ट इज क्लियर. वेरी गुड. तो एसिडिक सॉल्ट की पीएच बेटा इज ऑलवेज लेस देन 7 बिकॉज एसिड इज द डोमिनेटिंग कॉम्पोनेंट इन दिस पर्टिकुलर सॉल्ट. ठीक है, ट्राई दिस क्वेश्चन गाइज. I'll mute all of you. I want you to think about it and answer this. I'll give 20 second time. Jaldi se answer karo. Let me end give the valid. पहले ब्रेक करो बेटा सॉल्ट्स को, फाइंड आउट करो कौन सा एसिड था कौन सा बेस था, और एसिड वीक है या स्ट्रॉन्ग है, बेस वीक है या स्ट्रॉन्ग है, बेस्ड ऑन दैट हम लोग फिगर आउट कर सकते हैं. ठीक है, ऐसे रैंडम गेस मत करो प्लीज, इसको सॉल्व करो फिर आंसर बताओ. ओके, कई बच्चों ने ऑप्शन सी और डी भी मार्क कर दिया है. अब मुझे नहीं पता कैसे मार्क किया है क्योंकि हमारे पास तो ऑप्शन सी एंड डी है भी नहीं. देखो सोडियम कार्बोनेट, सोडियम क्या बेटा हमारा एन ए प्लस कार्बोनेट है, सीओ थ्री टू माइनस. ठीक है, तो सोडियम प्लस से रिलेटेड बेस हमारा हो जाएगा एन ए एच, कार्बोनेट से रिलेटेड बेस हमारा एसिड हो जाएगा हमारा एस टू सी ओ थ्री. ठीक है, NaOH क्या है बेटा हमारा स्ट्रॉन्ग बेस, H2CO3 क्या है हमारा वीक एसिड. ठीक है, सो नाउ दिस इज सॉल्ट ऑफ वीक एसिड एंड स्ट्रॉन्ग बेस. व्हाट टाइप ऑफ सॉल्ट इज दिस? इट्स अ बेसिक सॉल्ट एंड द डोमिनेटिंग पार्ट इज बेस, द नेचर विल बी बेसिक. ओके, सो लेट मी एंड द वैलिड, आई विल अनम्यूट यू. जल्दी से बताओ इफ दिस पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन इज क्लियर. एवरीवन tell me quickly if this particular question is clear. Very good, very good. Okay, now the next important topic is this, properties of salt. Properties of salt. Theek hai, dekho there are four main properties related to salt. First, water of crystallization, efflorescence, deliquescence, and hygroscopic thing. Okay, so let me mute all of you, then I'll explain one by one. Dekho. First, water of crystallization. Dekho. Those water molecules which are attached to salt with weak bond, those water molecules which are attached with salt with weak bond, this is the weak bond, those water molecules are known as water of crystallization. Okay, so water molecule associated with crystal of any salt is known as water of crystallization. Let's write some example. Jaise hamara Na2CO3 dot 10H2O, ye hamare 10 molecules of water ke kya hai hamare वॉटर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशन. ठीक है, इसका नाम क्या है बेटा हमारा? वॉशिंग सोडा. करेक्ट. सिमिलरली अनदर एग्जाम्पल, वेरी नोन एग्जाम्पल हमारे पास क्या है? CuSO4.5H2O. इसका नाम है हमारा ब्लू विट्रियॉल. ठीक है, अनदर एग्जाम्पल हमारे पास है CaSO4.2H2O. क्या है हमारा बेटा नाम? जिप्सम. ठीक है, इन दिस सॉल्ट फाइव मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ वाटर आर वाटर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशन. इसमें दो वाटर के मॉलिक्यूल्स हैं वाटर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशन. तो बेटा जल्दी से बताओ if this particular concept is clear. Water of crystallization. Everyone. Now I'll go to the question of the day. You remember I told there is a one question related to question of the day. Jaldi se usko answer karo yaar. Simple hai ab. Okay. I'm giving you 10 second time. Jaldi se khatam kar do. Then we'll go for the next topic. Okay, now I'll end the wallet. Let's see what is the color of this. Okay, yes, the correct answer is blue to white. Kya hai beta mera copper sulfate. Okay, in dry tested. So when copper sulfate is present in normal condition, kya hota hai? It contains 5 water molecules. When it is heated, it forms CuSO4 plus 5H2O. Abhi jaise maine discuss kiya, it is blue vitriol and it forms white color powder. Okay, and this white powder is amorphous in nature. Okay, this white color powder is amorphous in nature. Jaldi se batao ye question clear hai ki nahi hai, jaldi se batao, then I'll discuss the, I'll give the point. चलो जल्दी से कॉइन ले लो एवरीवन, इट्स अ लॉटरी वन. ओके लेट मी एंड. अच्छा बताओ जल्दी से, मजा आया कि नहीं आया कॉइन लेके? कूल cool. चलो हम लोग नेक्स्ट टॉपिक डिस्कस करेंगे. वाटर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशन इज क्लियर और उसकी बेसिस पे क्वेश्चन. जल्दी बताओ बेटा इसका क्या करेक्ट आंसर है. आई एम गिविंग द वैलिड. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग डज नॉट कंटेन वाटर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशन. मैंने सारे एग्जाम्पल डिस्कस किए हुए हैं, ये भी ये भी ये भी और ये भी. अब जल्दी से बताओ विच डू नॉट कंटेन डज नॉट कंटेन वाटर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशन. देखो लेट मी एक्सप्लेन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल मीट ऑल ऑफ यू. ब्लू विट्रियॉल इज CuSO4.5H2O. जिप्सम के बारे में बात किया था, CaSO4.2H2O. वॉशिंग सोडा भी बात किया था अपन ने, Na2CO3.10H2. व्हाट इज बेकिंग सोडा? बेकिंग सोडा इज NaHCO3. And it does not contain water or crystallization. I think this part is clear to everyone now, right? So what will be the correct answer? Baking soda. So jaldi se batao agar ye part clear hai. Jaldi se batao everyone. Okay, very good. चलो नेक्स्ट पार्ट हम लोग डिस्कस करते हैं इफ्लोरेसेंस के बारे में. इफ्लोरेसेंस इज जस्ट अ फिनोमेना. जब भी आप एक सॉल्ट को जो वाटर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशन से अटैच्ड है, एनी सॉल्ट विच हैज वाटर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशन इज एक्सपोज टू एटमॉस्फेयर, देन दोज वाटर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशन आर रिमूव्ड. दिस फिनोमेना इज नोन एज इफ्लोरेसेंस. And the compounds are known as efflorescent. The phenomena of removal of water of crystallization is known as efflorescence, and the compounds are known as efflorescent substance. Clear? So example, जैसे अपन ने देखा था FeSO4.7H2O. आप उसको हीट करोगे, it form FeSO4 plus 7H2O. So what is happening? These 7 water molecules are removed and it is green vitriol. इज इट क्लियर अबाउट इफ्लोरेसेंस गाइस? टेल मी क्विकली. वेरी गुड. नाउ अनदर इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म इज डेलिक्यूसेंस. देखो, एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ मॉइस्चर फ्रॉम एयर एंड दे विल डिजॉल्व इन इट टू फॉर्म सोल्यूशन. देखो क्या होता है, जैसे सॉल्ट है, इसको आप ओपन एटमोसफियर पे रख दो, क्या करेगा ये सॉल्ट ओपन एटमोसफियर से मॉइस्चर एब्जॉर्ब कर लेगा. आफ्टर एब्जॉर्बिंग द मॉइस्चर इट विल मिक्स इन टू द मॉइस्चर टू कन्वर्ट इन टू सोल्यूशन. ठीक है, तो जैसे सॉल्ट है हमारा, ठीक है, इसने क्या किया, मॉइस्चर एब्जॉर्ब की ऐसे करके. After absorbing the moisture, it is converted into solution. Okay, these kind of salts are known as, or these kind of compounds are known as deliquescents. Example: sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, calcium chloride. Is it clear, everyone? The basic definition of deliquescents. Everyone. Chalo. Let's discuss the next one, hygroscopic. The difference between deliquescent and hygroscopic is simple. Deliquescent will absorb the moisture and will convert into solution. But hygroscopic kya honge? They will absorb the moisture, but they will not mix into that. Okay? So they will absorb the moisture, but they will not mix into that. They are known as hygroscopic in nature. Okay, so now, certain substance absorb moisture from the atmosphere without undergoing change in physical state. That kind of phenomena is known as hygroscopic phenomena, and the substance are known as hygroscopic substance. Example: anhydrous sodium carbonate, Na2CO3, anhydrous copper sulfate, concentrated H2SO4. So all of you, just tell me quickly if these concepts are clear. Everyone, fluorescence, water crystallization, deliquescence, and hygroscopic. Perfect. So now we will go for some question. After that, I'll give the mic X. Chalo. This particular question. While diluting acid, why it is recommended that acid should be added to water, not water to the acid? Dekho, suppose we have acid here, right? Now we are adding water. This reaction is highly exothermic in nature. Okay, it can cause damage. Okay, that's why it is not recommended. So now what is recommended? We need to add acid into water. Okay, so easily heat is released and absorbed by the water. Okay, this is the correct reason. Is it clear, everyone? Why water is not added into acid? Because reaction will be highly exothermic and it can cause damage. But in reverse case, we have water, a small amount of acid is added. Whenever heat is released, it is absorbed by the water. Correct? Is it clear, everyone? Press one quickly. Okay, now this question, guys, you can answer it. Which of the following is used to dissolve gold? Jaldi se batao. Bahut simple question hai. Everyone, answer this. Dekho, gold, platinum, they are considered as noble metals. Okay, to dissolve these, we need only aqua regia. Okay, And aquaresia is the correct answer. What is aquaresia, guys? 3 part HCl plus 1 part HNO. Okay? So 3 part HCl and 1 part HNO3 is aquaresia. Is it clear, everyone? Option B is correct answer. Aquaresia. Let me end the ballot. Let's go for the next question. Chalo. Jaldi se isko answer karo. And this is our last question. Then I'll go for mic access. Everyone, this is our last question. Okay. When it is usually passed through the guard tube containing calcium chloride, the role of calcium chloride taken in this particular thing. Okay, this is second last question. We'll be doing one more question. Okay. Now, calcium chloride is deliquescent compound. We have written anhydrous calcium chloride. It is deliquescent compound. It absorbs the moisture, right? Calcium chloride is deliquescent compound. It absorbs the moisture. So based on that, mark it correctly. Quickly, guys, 5 more seconds. It's a deliquescent. The correct answer will be option B. It absorbs the moisture from the atmosphere. Chalo. And this is our last question, guys. Fresh milk has pH 6. When it is changes into curd, what will be the pH value? pH increases or decreases? Yes. So when milk is converted into yogurt, pH decreases. So the correct answer will be option B. Okay. Is it clear to everyone? Yes, I can give the ballot anyway. Now everyone knows the answer. So option B will be our correct answer. Because acid is produced when milk is converted into yogurt, acid is produced. Lactobacillus bacteria.